film. And this is the New York City refrigeration test preparation. My first question is, which of the following methods would be used to clean the tubes of a condenser? A. Blowing down the condenser. B. Manually punching the tubes. C. Add soda ash to the condenser water. D. Add acid to the condenser water. The answer, of course, would be B. Manually punching the tubes. Over time, the water cool condenser does get dirty inside the tubes. Removing the ends and using a very small brush to punch the tubes is the best way to clean them. Question number two. At what load capacity should a compressor be loaded when it is started? A. Start at the lowest capacity. B. Start at the highest capacity. C. 50%. D. 75%. Of course, the answer would be A. Start at the lowest capacity. If you remember Newton's law, which states a body in motion tends to remain in motion, a body at rest tends to remain at rest. The principle of Newton's law is that usually it's difficult to start, but once started, it's easier to remain or to continue going. It's no different with the compressor. When you start the compressor, it's best to start it without a load, because that's the most difficult part, starting. Once started, then fine, you can add the load because the compressor is already in motion. So it's best, if possible, to start the compressor with the least load. Our next question is, which of the following best describes a normally closed solenoid valve? A. Is held closed by an electromagnetic field. B. Is held open by spring pressure. C. Is held closed by spring pressure. Or D. Acts as a relief valve. The answer, of course, is C. Is held closed by spring pressure. The solenoid valve is an electromechanical valve. Supplying electrical power will put the valve in one direction. Removing electrical power, the valve will go in another direction. If the valve is normally closed, that means without power, the valve is closed. When you supply power, then the valve goes in the opposite direction, which means it will open. You remove power, the valve goes back to a closed position. There's usually a spring that's used to keep it in that closed position until you supply power. Our next question is, after opening an electrical enclosure, an RMO observed that there are three wires, two of which are fused. What can be said about this electrical arrangement? A. The unfused wire does not need to be insulated. B. The unfused wire is a neutral in a 120 to 40 volt circuit. C. The unfused wire is a sphere and can be used if the insulation of the other conductors fail. D. If a fuse is added to the unfused wire, the circuit can be operated as a three-phase system. The answer, of course, is B. The unfused wire is a neutral in the 120 to 40 volt circuit. Normally, the power wires are fused. The unfused wire is usually the common that's used. If you need 120 volts, you use one power wire with the common or the unfused wire. Now, if you need 208 or 240 volt single phase, then you use a two hot wire. Question 5. There are two refrigeration systems. System A operates with a suction pressure of 18 psig and a speed of 230 rpm. It is absorbing 800 BTUs per minute in its evaporator. The second system, system B, is operating with a suction pressure of 22 psig and a speed of 300 rpm. It is absorbing 600 BTUs per minute from a brain tank. From the data given, it can be said that A is producing 3 tons and B is producing 4 tons. B, A is producing 4 tons and B is producing 4 tons. C, A is producing 4 tons and B is producing 3 tons. D, A is producing 3 tons and B is producing 3 tons. The answer, of course, is C. A is producing 4 tons and B is producing 3 tons. 12,000 BTUs per hour equals a ton. System A produced 800 BTUs per minute. System B produced 600 BTUs per minute. Multiply those numbers by 60, we will receive how many tons of BTU is being produced per hour. And of course, we come to answer C, which is A is producing 4 tons and B is producing 3 tons.